Hello guys, Alex here, and Magikarp Community Day is right around the corner, so let's just see what will be the specifications for this event, and let's begin. So as you all know, today on the 8th of August, from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. local time, we will have Magikarp Community Day, and as you know, during this time period Magikarp will be appearing more in the wild. So what actually we have bonuses for this 6 hours, so Incense will be working 3 hours as during the previous Community Days, as for Abra, as was C-Dot, as was for Ghastly and Widow. Also we have triple catch Stardust, so it's actually a really good time to grind for Stardust. So I will just use my star piece, so I will get more Stardust that it is possible and it is allowed. Also during this time period, plus 2 hours after the end of the Community Day, so up until the 7 p.m. if you will involve your Magikarp into Gallardus, Gallardus will know Aquatail as his new water type charge move. Will it influence on meta? In PvP, I actually don't know, so we have to wait and see. I think that actually, as Gallardus had only Hydro Pump before as his water type charge attack, now he will have Aqua Tail, which charge way faster. So I think that it will increase, at least for the PvE, it will be better. But anyway, for PvE we have Kyogre, which is the best water type Pokemon currently in the game. So yeah, before we will move to the Magikarp Community Day research, which you will able to buy in the shop for one US dollar or the equivalent in your currency. So yeah, no shiny Magikarp for me yet. I actually had 5, so it's not so exciting event, and I think that it's not so exciting event for most of people, but well, we have to do what we have to do. So let's begin our Professor Willow research, what he will tell us. So he's saying to us, do you hear the sound? Like, it's a really nice sound. It is the sound of something splashing on the water. Also, it's Magikarp and he is splashing quite a lot. I wonder if he is training his splash. So he is really big Pokemon, and he actually doesn't help in any way, but I think that there is no disadvantages in catching it. Of course, he is a weak Pokemon, but we cannot disregard possibilities that he will become stronger. So for the first task, we have to power up Pokemon 10 times, catch 15 Magikarps, and make 5 nice throws. So let's use already Incense. And also let's use, as we will be playing, as we will be catching quite a lot of Pokemon today, so let's go with Lucky Egg. I have a lot of them, so whatever, and Star Piece. And let's begin. I was invited for Deoxys raid. It is my first raid for Deoxys, and it's actually, I hope that I will catch it, so it will be my first one. It's from one of my friends, again, through Twitter, from Japan. So let's check if it is shiny. No, it's simple, but was I really expecting shiny Deoxys for the first ever raid for Deoxys? Of course not. It was actually quite fast. It was faster. It was on the second or third ball. It has terrible IVs, but hey, it is the first one, so let it be in this way. Let's quickly check with Magikarps what we have here. Maybe we will have shiny. And yeah, I hate when this happens. So yeah, okay, no shinies for me. I have finished two tasks for the research, but we have to power up 10 Pokemons yet. So what I do, I go, I sort my Pokemon by the CP range, but not the higher CP range, but by the lower CP range. And there you found Pokemon that has the lowest CP. And if you don't have any Pokemon that you are planning to fully upgrade, like for example me currently, I don't have any Pokemon and I don't want to spend a lot of Stardust, you go find the lowest CP ones that you have a lot of candies for. For me, it will be Beldum. You see it's CP only 38, and you just go and power up it 10 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, let's go and power it up. And we have finished tasks that we have to power up Pokemon 10 times. Let's again check. No, it's not shiny, so okay. And let's just go and finish our first resort. So we get our 10 Pokeballs, 20 Magikarp candies, and I think that it will be Magikarp. Okay, it's Magikarp, we have to catch it. Let's claim this one. So 2000 Stardust, 10 pineapple berries, 10 pineapple berries, and another Magikarp, which is not shiny. Okay, and this community day. So for me, it is actually would not be something like, oh, I've spent so much time, I didn't get anything. It's currently this community day is more for grinding experience if you need one, and for grinding Stardust, mainly for grinding Stardust. So maybe you don't know, but Magikarp can splash. I don't know how he can splash up to the high places, but as it's written here, Magikarp can splash up to the high places, and he even can splash over the mountain. So he has a really strong life thing. He can feel himself really good in dirty water or muddy water. Professor Willu saying that he thinks that we should think about this specification. So yeah, value all this jumping over the mountain, living in dirty water, long livability, etc., etc., etc. Yeah, nothing interesting. And also research the evolution of this Pokemon. And as always, use a lot of pineapple berries, which I like. And now we have to catch 15 Magikarps. Send to the professor 10 Pokemon, which also will be Magikarps in this case. And use 15 pineapple berries while catching Pokemon. I have finished the second part of Magikarp Community Day research, but before we will claim all of this rewards, I would like to check what we have in the shop. So in the Community Day box for Magikarp Community Day, we have 30 Ultra Balls, 1 Incense, 6 Star Pieces, and 1 Elite, what is it? Sugoi was a machine special. If you need something from this box, you can buy it, but actually, in my opinion, it doesn't worth it, because if you're playing in Go Battle League and you have reached at least the seventh ring, it was in the first season, you actually got one. So I don't see any reason for buying this box, but if you need, you can buy it. And we have for Magikarp Community Day, we have 33 Ultra Balls, so let's go and claim them. Okay, and let's just claim our reward. So we get 50 Magikarp candies, which is nice, 500 Stardust, 1000 experience, and 2000 Stardust, 1 incense, and 1 Puffin. Okay, so thank you, Alex Miro. We have finished research for the Magikarp, and the next one is evolution. It evolves into the very strong Gallardus and other stuff. So it's quite interesting that he changes so drastically after the evolution, and that he evolves from the pure water type to water and flying type, which is actually quite interesting for researchers. You need to pay attention and make Gallardus one of your friends. So in the third part, we need to make three great curveballs, evolve one magic carp as it was in the previous researches for community days. You always have to evolve Pokemon. So it is here, and again send 10 Pokemon to the professor. Third portion of the Magikarp research is done. Let's claim our reward: 50 Magikarp candies, 5 golden raspberries, 150 XP, then 2000 Stardust, 1 incense, and 1 Rocket Raider. Okay, we have added Gallardus to our friends. He will help with the trainer battles and with the battles against Team Go Rocket. Actually, how to use Gallardus depends on the trainer. And he is really expecting to see what will be the actions, how will be our interactions with Gallardus. Left it in the gym if it is really behaving really bad, and so on and so forth. He will come back to the research and we will see him later. Of course, we will see him later. And yes, so we have actually finished the research. So let's claim our last reward. It will be 5,000 Stardust, 150 XP, 5 Silver Pineapples, and 2,000 Stardust, 3 Rare Candies, and it will be Gallardus. Of course, it will be Gallardus with Aqua Tail. And we have finished Magikarp research. Let's appraise it. It's not actually really good. Let me just check. No, it's not shiny. And this one is also not shiny. And this one is also not shiny, I'm sure. Yeah. So currently I've managed to get for the 1 whole hour, I managed to get only one with IVs. I've been invited for another Deoxys raid. We have done it, and let's see if we will get shiny. And no. Okay, as for the result of Magikarp community today, I'll see you in the end. I plan to do only 3 hours, so let's see how many shinies I will be able to get in these 3 hours, only staying at home and with incense.
2 hours later.
So we are 3.5 hours in. My incense has finished, expired, whatever. And I just want to share my results. I have already deleted everything that has bad IVs, that is like trash. So we will go through the shinies. None of my shinies has a good IVs, as you can see. Only this one actually can be good for, it has PvP-ish stats, so we can use it for PvP. And from all of the, and speaking about other, I got 198. I didn't get any 100 Magikarp, but one is 98. Another one is 96, again 98, and another one was 98. And I got one which is actually the best version for PvP. It has full, it has 15 defense and 15 HP, and it has zero attack. So it is the best for PvP based on stats. So I've already checked all the information about Gallardus in PvP. It's not quite useful for Great League or for Mastery, but it can be used for Ultra League. So, and Aqua Tail is it is not one of the best, it's not actually the best, but it is, it can be used in PvP. So let's just evolve this one. I had quite a lot of candies, so it's not a problem for me anyway. So we will just evolve it. It should have around 500 CP, if I'm not mistaken, if I'm calculated and checked everything correctly, or 700, something between. Oh, it has 622, okay. And let's just open the second attack, so it will be already done. No, I don't need hyper pump, let's change it. I've checked it, the best variant should be crunch, so let's just go and check it for check hydro pump for crunch, not outrage, not this one. Okay, so it's crunch. So basically, yeah, so basically this is my result for the Magic Arab community day. I'm not planning to use another incense for another 3 hours, so this will be the end. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!